Hi, I'm Jimmy Travis, Tinchville Parish candidate for sheriff and proud sponsor of Action News 17's 2023 coverage of our fairs and festivals. We are known for these events that celebrate the culture and traditions of our beloved Tinchville Parish. Remember to stay safe, have a plan, and don't drink and drive.
Well, festival season is upon us. Nobody knows that any better than Mike Whitlow. He is the Grand Marshal for the Krewe of Erin that will roll, or more precisely, march on Saturday here in Ponchatoula. And I don't know if it starts festival season because, boy, around here it seems like we've been partying since Mardi Gras, but it certainly has become a mainstay here.
Yeah, it has, Ken. You know, it's a real honor when they came to my wife and I a few months back and asked us, you know, if we'd be the Grand Marshal of the parade. It's a real honor. You know, this is the 39th year of the Krewe of Erin. We have a full court. We had a coronation last week. And, you know, they've been around a while, and it's an interesting tradition, you know, pushing grocery carts and handing out cabbages and potatoes and carrots and onions and stuff like that. A real family event, which is really what Ponchatoula is all about.
So let's just describe it for people who have never seen one. Everybody marches with shopping carts, and you throw cabbages and potatoes and things like that.
There's no motorized vehicles are allowed. The Ponchatoula High School Band will be leading the way. And then you'll have the court and then all the members and their extended families and extended families and, you know, all those kind of things. But that's correct. On Friday night, they have what they call a cart raid. And basically, I think it's Rouse's this year has donated the use of the carts. So they'll go pick up all the carts, the grocery carts, start decorating them and loading them. And it's like a St. Patrick's or a Mardi Gras parade, just with grocery carts.
Some guys show up in kilts.
Some show up in kilts. We had a few in kilts last weekend. I will not be in kilts. I was told I could do that, and my wife vetoed that program.
But, I mean, it's just so much fun, and what I like about it is that there are some very loose rules. Yeah. I mean, it's not really structured.
No, it really isn't. It's just the biggest rule is just have a good time. And, you know, be safe and those sort of things. And, you know, it's been really, really good. And the police department has been really great working with us, the Ponchatoula PD, you know, with the route and extended the route this year a little bit, which is a good thing, too.
Well, by picking this particular weekend, I mean, you're going to get a big crowd because there are other events going on in Ponchatoula.
Yeah, you have, a car show. You have the gumbo cook-off contest. You have trade days, which just brings an enormous amount of people to this city twice a year. That's a really huge event. And the gumbo cook-off is a big event.
As a Krewe, I wonder if you guys talked about maybe doing it on another day, or did you like the idea that there'd be all these other people there?
You know, I really don't know what the criteria for that is. I know they've always done it prior to St. Patrick's Day, because, you know, a lot of people like to go participate in St. Patrick's Day, you know, in Baton Rouge or New Orleans or, you know, Jefferson or wherever. And it's been like that. It's the 23 years I've been up here. It's always been before St. Patrick's Day. So I don't know. I wasn't real involved in that process and that decision making.
So what does a Grand Marshal get to do?
Well, I'm going to be dressed in white tails. I'm going to wear my green hat and all my green paraphernalia that goes with it. And I have mine, I think I can get this pronounced, it's a cane, I think they call it Kaylee. It's really, I think I got that right. It's really, really cool. It's a nice thing. And then I'll be walking, handing out flowers and that sort of stuff.
So the parade starts at 10:30?
Starts at 10:30 and it'll hit Highway 22 right by the station, right by where Bonings is, that grocery store, and then it'll go down 22. And this year we'll be going all the way across the tracks and disband at the Ponchatoula Methodist Church on the east side.
In the meantime, though, I hear that there'll be a big event, sort of, in the middle of the parade at the country market.
Yeah, at the country market, which is what you mentioned earlier, where so many people are going to be for the trade days and for the gumbo cook-off. The city is going to issue a proclamation, and they're going to give that to the royalty at that point. And there also will be, I think the country market has a special presentation from what I hear they're going to be making. And there may be others, I don't know, we'll see. But it's great that everybody's getting involved and the merchants are getting involved. It's a really, really good thing for the city.
I'm Tangipahoa Parish Sheriff Daniel Edwards inviting you to come enjoy one of our great festivals. Be sure not to drink and drive and secure your valuables in the trunk of your locked car. And if you experience any problems, be sure to speak with one of our deputies, Laissez-les bon temps relais, and stay safe.